he's doing right here?
That's a farmer job. Well, we're back again, and today we're working on garden boxes. We're getting a start on building our garden box. This is the first one we're doing, so it's kind of a prototype, but we have a little idea in our head. We've looked at a bunch of pictures of all you people out there who love garden boxes and got your pictures out there on the internet, and we want something like that, so we're gonna make some. The plan is to make a 2 by 8 foot grow box. And we're using pressure treated wood for the frame, but we're going to use galvanized sheet metal for the box. And the reason I'm doing that is I don't want pressure treated wood coming into contact with our soil. So we're gonna start here with marking up some boards. And I think I have a helper here that's gonna mark these boards for me. Let's mark them at every 2 feet. Okay, so in order to build these panels for the grow box, we used a couple of tools. We used this Craig jig to drill our corners and screw our screws in. That Craig jig will allow you to drill a hole in here that just sets this screw right in there real nice. One, two, three, it's kind of wobbly. And then you stick a 3-inch screw on the end of it and it's like, control that. Wow.
Did you do it right here?
That's a farmer job. Okay, it looks like we got a panel made. The first panel out of these grow boxes. We had a couple of little snafus, but we got it figured out. All right, so what we've done is we've taken our pressure treated wood, cut it to the right dimensions. We use this Craig drill jig, say that 10 times fast, to connect our pressure treated studs together. And then we laid our sheet metal over the top of it and screwed the sheet metal down. It's pretty rigid. It feels like it's going to be pretty sturdy. Okay. We have finished our first grow box. It feels pretty sturdy, looks pretty good, I think. So our final step on this thing, after we attached the ends and put the frame together, was to put a rim around the top. So we've done that, just to dress it up a bit and also to kind of protect fingers from the metal underneath. But I think it's all done. So we've gone over this box with you and showed you all the steps that we took in building it. We're also going to create a plan. So if you're interested in a detailed plan of how we did it and you want some instructions on sizes of wood to cut and metal and things like that, we'll put together a little ebook for you or instruction book so you can download that. We'll put a link down in the description below. So we're going to be doing more of these boxes and we're going to change our design up a little bit each time and experiment with it. It's already been suggested to us that this is too skinny, too narrow. So we're going to try on the next one to make it a little bit wider. So we'll give you all the details on that as well.
You finished it.
Yeah, we got the first grow box done.
It looks like it's time to put some strawberries in there.
Yep, we need to fill it with dirt or soil and get some plants in it.
I guess we'll do that next time, huh?
Yep, on the next video, we're going to do a different size grow box, so stay tuned.
All right, we'll see you next time.
All right, thank you.
Bye. Don't forget to subscribe for more growing, creating, and sipping videos. If you enjoy this video, you might also like this video here.